This is NDTV. And you're watching Classics.
Friends, can you hear me?
Yeah.
All of you?
Yeah.
One thing I find, all of you smiling.
That's because you're here.
You know, smiling is a fantastic thing. You know about it? The smile, if you smile, the whole day will be smiling. If you don't smile, day will not smile. So it's like, make it a habit to smile. It creates a lot of friendship, a lot of happiness. Okay? Now,
okay. You smile, but you also ask some tough questions.
No, they will ask me. Don't worry. They will ask me for that.
I want to introduce you to all our audience around the country and around the world. Mr. Abdul Kalam, Dr. Abdul Kalam, one of India's most popular presidents. Would you say so?
Yeah.
He was the president.
He was?
Correction.
Should he still be the president?
Yeah.
Would you like to still be in the president?
So, already we are a democratic country, naturally a process has gone through. Now I am very happy what I am doing.
I got
a plate full, like these young people, I'll be teaching them, doing research, or very interesting things I am going to do, okay?
Did you enjoy the presidency while it was there?
Oh, beautiful years, 5 years, beautiful years.
So 5 more beautiful years would have been nice.
Now, I want to talk to you something, okay? You are coming from different schools, Delhi?
Yeah. Oh, colleges,
Delhi College.
Yeah, colleges.
You are all from Delhi College?
Yes.
But from different parts of the country.
Uh-huh.
You are studying
okay.
Here.
That's okay. So from Delhi College, right?
Various colleges in Delhi.
I want to ask you, all of you, my email is apj.abdulkalam.com. Okay?
apj.abdulkalam.com.
apj@abdulkalam.com. Okay? That's my website, www.abdulkalam.com. Okay? Now, one question I'm going to ask you. All of you, at least few of you should respond. The first question, what I will be remembered for? What? Repeat it. What? What I will be remembered
Who
for?
Who wants to answer that?
No.
At the back there, she wants to answer
okay,
that question.
Okay.
One second, just the girl in the blue, yes. What will Dr. Kalam be remembered for?
Not me. Each one of you.
Oh, each one of you.
Each one of you.
Oh, okay.
Not Kalam and you. Don't worry about
okay,
Kalam.
Okay, both things. What will you be remembered?
Each one of you. What, that question I put forth, what I will be remembered for?
Each one of you.
Each one, what I will be remembered.
Okay, first.
Will you be remembered? I will give you some sort of indication. Will you be remembered as a great scientist, say, Thomas Alva Edison, who gave a meaning to the electricity? Or will you like to be remembered like our Sir C.V. Raman, who was a Nobel Prize winner for physics? Or will you like to be remembered as a mathematician who was Srinivasa Ramanujan, number 3, who gave to the India? Or would you like to remember like Einstein E=mc², he discovered today, it made a lot of difference to the life of human beings. So, something you must cling to that. After all...
Sir, can I just ask you, All these things are great. What happens if you are just remembered as a good human being?
No. Let them say that. Let them say that.
Okay, the young girl there. Yeah, what will you be remembered for, and what will Dr. President, ex-President Kalam be remembered for?
Professor.
Professor.
Good evening, sir.
Yes.
Sir, I'm Mehjubeen Hussain. Sir, I would love to be remembered as someone who gave her all for her motherland.
All for her motherland.
Whatever I have given it for my motherland. I would be really remembered.
You're a fantastic girl. You're a fantastic girl.
And sir,
anyone of you.
She's
and
got a
sir,
second
you
point.
Would be remembered as a person who is the best example of simple living and high thinking. Very, very high thinking.
Yeah. Simple living and high thinking.
We wish you all the very best. A long and a very long life and good health, because India does need people like you.
Thank you.
Professor Kalam, well, you've got an answer to the question.
I would be like to remembered as like through my writings, because I'm into creative writing. So I would want to shake up all the issues that are lying dormant in India and try to awaken people and increase their awareness. And
then you should join NDTV.
Definitely, I'm all for it.
Okay, and
no, writer is a beautiful mission.
Beautiful thing.
Beautiful mission. Yes, go ahead.
And you, sir, will be remembered for teaching us how to dream, and that dreams transform into thoughts, and thoughts transform into
beautiful.
Actions. That is really motivating.
Well, sir, this side is silent. This side is silent.
Come, this side is silent. Yeah, this young lady here in the front. With the headband. Yeah, go ahead.
Good evening, sir. I guess you'll be remembered for the most straightforward scientific politician.
I'm asking you.
She called you a scientific politician.
Most straightforward scientific politician.
Yes.
And I think I'll be remembered as a good social activist.
Social activist. Oh,
yeah.
Okay. Beautiful. Very nice. Men folk is silent. Yes.
Just here in the front row here, in the black and white.
Yes.
Yeah. Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
My name is Harsh.
Yeah.
I think I'll be remembered as the greatest friend a person can have.
Oh, greatest friend.
Yes.
That's lovely.
Beautiful. Something unique.
And I think you'll be remembered as the most non-controversial president India ever had.
We're here in the residence where Professor Kalam is going to stay. You can see it's under renovation. I must give you a little anecdote of what happened today. It was pouring with rain all day. So we said, Professor Kalam, this is going to be very difficult to have the program today. And he said, I'm a scientist. I tell you, it will not rain. And it hasn't rained. So you're a meteorologist also.
I'd like to be.
Ask your question again.
That question.
I would like you to ask that whether that the vision for India 2020, that it will become a superpower, will it be realized taking the present conditions of India into
mind? Yeah. I got your question. But you know, first of all, it's not Kalam's vision. You said Kalam's vision 2020. It's a national vision. A nation which does not have a vision. Many civilizations collapsed because that civilization does not have a vision. So vision is a very important for national development, and India has the vision India 2020 to transforming India into a developed nation. Now what does it mean? It means we are billion people. About 220 million people are below poverty line. So the aim is, if you push up these 220 million people from the poverty line, then definitely a developed India, economically developed India will come. You are asking, is it possible? The one of the tool we have to have is GDP, gross domestic product, economic growth. He's a big economist, he's a PhD in economy. My friend.
You're a better economist actually.
So that 10% GDP growth is feasible, our finance minister says. We are at 9%. So if you have a 10% GDP growth and maintain it for a decade, definitely the economically developed India is possible. But now you can ask me, what are the tools? What are the tools we have? That's the question is there. The tools, we have identified five areas. agriculture, agro-food processing. We should work on agro-food processing, you know. Second one, education and healthcare combined. Education for women folk, for particularly women education, is the highest priority. Wherever in our country women education has been done, that state has got a healthy state, and also it has got small families emerged. So that's why we combined education, healthcare together. Third thing, our core competence, that is information and communication technology, we are doing very well. Then the most important, infrastructure developments. Fifth area, self-reliance in critical technology. Now, what is the self-reliance critical technology? For example, 1998, when India became nuclear weapon state, what happened? What happened? India became 1998. India became a nuclear weapon state. What happened? That is the economic, yes, you are right, economic sanction was there and also technological sanction. But because our farmers...
Just one second, when nuclear state, are you in favor of the bomb?
No, India became a nuclear weapon state means everything is there. You generate the power, the
yes,
electricity you generate.
But the bomb, are you in
you
favor?
Make, you make when the, the country needs, when all around you have... All around.
So you're not answering.
No, when you have all around nuclear weapon, you cannot do dabas, isn't that? You have to have strength.
So it's good.
You all repeat. You are all repeat. Strength, strength, respects,
strength.
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 That is the answer to my friend.
So you're in favor of the bomb. Strength, respect,
okay.
Strength.
So
okay, let's ask another. Get some other questions.
Yes.
Here in the front row, here the lady in the striped T-shirt. Yes.
Isn't it a problem for the world peace?
Pardon?
When you are in favor of a bomb, isn't it a problem for the world peace?
World peace is very important, okay? How the world peace comes? World peace comes on a three-dimensional approach. According to me, I have given a formula. First one, what is the three-dimensional approach for world peace? Education with value system. All you children. For example, when you are studying college, St. Joseph's College, my Reverend Father Rector will come. 1 hour every Monday, he will give a lecture on moral science. He will talk to Lord Buddha. He will talk Augustine. He will talk, and then Khalifa Omar. He will talk about, and then he will talk about Einstein. He will talk about Abraham Lincoln, and their life, how they became great by their way of life. So, what is essentially is education with value system. 1 hour in the classroom. Every week there should be education value. I am propagating throughout wherever I go. I am propagating.
Are you satisfied with the answer?
No, I have not given the
answer.
You
are not finished yet. Okay.
So answer to your question, there's a three-dimensional approach for peace. Okay. This I have propagated.
No, but her question was?
Won't it endanger the world peace?
Will a bomb endanger world peace?
No,
that's
world peace, poverty.
No, bomb.
Poverty. Poverty and the value system, when there is a country has got a poverty, when the country does not have the value system, when there is a poverty and there is no value system, that is an endanger the peace.
So you ask her the question, do you think a bomb will affect...
No, I have convinced her.
A bomb doesn't affect world. Do you think it affects world peace?
Next question.
She's just answering. She thinks it affects world peace.
I want to tell you, bomb was there from 1945. Bomb is there. It was never used. Okay.
True.
Do you understand?
Right.
So it is. That's why I gave you a philosophy: strength, respect, strength. Okay. Okay.
So if you have the bomb, there'll be
no.
You
no,
don't need to use
no.
it.
What I'm saying. Bomb is only one of the elements, but most important thing is I have the three-dimensional approach, world peace. That is education value system,
right.
Transforming religion into a spiritual force, and third is removing the poverty.
So a lot of questions. We'll take a short break. When we come back, I know all of you want to know, Professor Kalam, does he think a president should be a politician or a non-politician? After the break. See you there. This very, very special India questions. The first time Professor Kalam, the ex-president of India, is speaking to the entire nation. And we got these young people asking questions. Before they ask the first question, president should be a politician or non-politician?
Hi, what type of question? Fantastic. You know, is a political question or what do you say? Is a political question? See, all of them say it's a political question. But I answer you. Answer is,
yeah.
The president, any president, my experience says, in Rashtrapati Bhavan,
yes.
Each president has brought a core competence. Somebody can be a lawyer, somebody can be a judge, somebody can be an educationalist, somebody a politician. Each one bring the core competence and enrich the Rashtrapati Bhavan. He or she should be a good human being. If a good human being, he will be the best president. Do you agree?
Can a politician be a good human being?
No, I have answered.
Okay, you don't have to answer.
I have answered.
Okay, now the next question. How about who hasn't asked? Okay, the girl in red here in the fourth row.
Good evening, sir.
Yeah, go ask your question.
Good evening, sir. I'm Prerna.
Yes.
My question is that with Pratibha Patil and Sonia Gandhi as the supreme heads of India today, India will face a kind of a feminist movement. What is your opinion on it?
You love it. You love it. You know, I personally believe this. From the last 5 years when I was a president, I was provocating with the 50% of the population of women folk. They deserve 33% in parliament. But so far, they have not put forth, the women folk, they have not put forth. If they are 30% in the assembly, state assembly, if they are 33% in the parliament, what change they will do? What change they will do in the parliament? What change they will do legislative assembly? Change means dynamic change.
Right.
This answer, whenever the team of women representatives come to me, that we want 33%, I tell them, you give me this answer.
Did they give you?
Partly, not fully. But you are, since a lot of you are girls are here, you must, what I feel in my mind, I want to tell you. You must say, in politics, there are, politics I defined in two parts. Politics equal to, one is political politics, another is developmental politics. Okay.
So the question was, is it good that women are in power in India?
Well, I believe that is definitely, that's why the parliament, parliament, that's right. The right place. Okay. Yeah.
So just one second, just to answer.
He's
that.
He's always pushing me.
Just to answer. This 33% reservation, you're for it for women?
I am for it.
You're for it. Very good. Next question, your round of applause.
Men also.
Next question. The young girl in orange or pink?
Pink,
all right. Yeah, go ahead.
Good evening, sir.
Good evening.
My name is Swati. My question is not about any bomb or the climate change. Mm. I just want to ask a general question. Mm. How was your life before becoming a president, and which life was more enjoyable, the life of a common man or the life of a president?
I will say that, first of all, my philosophy is whatever work you do, you love, then you'll be happy. But definite answer to your question, when I was a teacher, before joining the president, I was a happy fellow. Now I have gone back to teacher, happy fellow. Again, I become a happy fellow.
More positive
happy.
Spirit, there you are. Okay. We're going to ask Professor Kalam to tell us a secret which he promised to tell. Mm. You said, I have one view as president, I have another view after, and I'll tell you then. Do you believe in the death penalty?
Well, you see, the death penalty is a very rare cases, finally it comes from the Supreme Court, death penalty. Now, I believe, for example, there was a rape case, and a student, then I took a decision. Then, I also feel, it's a personal problem, I ask myself, what right you have to take a life, what right you have. So I am going through this type of phenomena. I think in a few months' time, I will have a definite proposal on that, how to handle. And also I found many of the cases, we have to lose the life. They are all coming from the low level strata of the society. So it gave me concern. But I have not made my thoughts for or against the capital punishment. But I'm thinking. That's all.
But did you give a lot of clemency? Like for Afzal, would you have given clemency?
No,
what would you recommend?
I told you already, this case, Afzal case, is not referred to me by the government still. Because, see, removing the life is not so simple issue.
Right.
The many process government goes through. So it is in the process. Okay? Next question.
Right, next question. No, okay, Sanjay Dutt, right.
Sir, if you are the judge of the, if you are the Chief Justice of India, would you grant leave to Sanjay Dutt?
Sanjay Dutt, the actor.
No, I personally believe, after all, law cannot be different from various people. Law cannot be different. Justice has to be every individual, whatever he deserves, he must get it. I'm very difficult for me to say whether X should get punishment or Y should not get punishment. Very difficult question. You should ask some law experts, okay?
The young girl in blue here in the second row from the right.
You always select blue. Yeah.
It has always been said that there is a woman behind a man's success. Who's the woman behind your success?
Well, I think all the 50% of the women of this country.
Good answer. Right.
And of course my mother.
And
my
your mother.
Mother, of course my mother.
Okay. We'll take a short break. You can see so many people want to ask questions. When we come back, we'll ask you some secrets you have to tell us from Rashtrapati Bhavan. That's in a moment from now. See you then. Back to this very special evening with Professor Abdul Kalam. Now we have a group of youngsters, this young, very enthusiastic girl in the front row here, left. Ask a question.
Good evening, my name is Pratishtha. I want to know, now that we have a woman president, do you think it will improve the status of women in our country?
Do you think it will?
Not much.
My feeling is, I have already told you, every president, you see, is not just giving you some data. I have studied all the 11 presidents, what they have done to Rashtrapati Bhavan. Every president has given something unique he brings, he or she will bring. So I personally believe this, the women president, definitely she will have certain core competence to give to the nation, okay?
Okay, another question. I can't take anybody in blue now. I have to take... Okay, you've already had a question. How about a young man somewhere? Okay, that young man there at the back in the orange. Yeah, go ahead.
I'm Abhishek Kaul. I just want to ask, is your hairstyle inspired by someone?
What is the question?
Is your hairstyle inspired by someone?
No, it is. It grows and then I shape it.
When did it start? When did you have this?
Oh, I'm having for college days, 1950s.
So you're basically a 60s child. Okay. Yeah, this young man in the front here with a very smart tie, the only young man with a... Yeah, looking really smart. Go ahead.
Sir, I would like to ask, religion versus individuality, what would you prioritize?
No, religion is a very private affair. Okay? It's a private affair. But see, the religion, I told you, has got two common, theology and spiritualism. But as a human beings, we should all we have to believe in one thing, that is nation, all of you repeat, nation is bigger than any other aspect in my country. Do you agree?
We agree. Everybody agrees. Great. So tell us one secret from the Rashtrapati Bhavan. When Sonia Gandhi came to see you, what did she ask you?
Naturally, she will bring all the majority. She will say, majority.
Did she want to become Prime Minister? Did she raise it at all?
No. These are all stories.
So she never asked you? Okay. She never asked you. One second. She never asked?
Yes, question please.
That's the answer. A voice from here. Okay, ask your question. Okay, ask yours. Ask us, go ahead.
Sir, today you are here among youth who'd like to be a doctor, a scientist or something else. But none of the youth would like to come forward towards politics. So how would you motivate the youth of today towards politics? Because I feel that the politics of India is in a really bad condition.
It's a very fantastic question. You know, everywhere when I go, 500 people, 1,000 people, sometime 100 people I address. I ask them, how many of you want to become engineers? Some hands. How many of you want to become doctors? Some hands will come. How many of you want to become the teachers? Some hand will come. How many of you want to become go to Mars? How many of you want to go to Mars? Mars want to.
Everybody.
Oh, I'll meet you there. Okay. By 2020, another 15 to 20 years time, man on the Mars, man on the moon is possible by our chairman, Indian Space Research Organization, Mr. Dr. Madhavan Iyer said he is planning to put a man on the moon, many UFO astronauts. So, but when I ask a question, how many want to become political leader? About few years back, there would not be any response. Now, girls and boys, many of them want to become political leaders. A good sign, because unless youth enter into the political system, the transformation will not take place. And I will give you, but if you don't have any other question, I'll give you a
lots of questions.
I will have a big
How
big
many
story.
Of you want to be president, like Professor Kalam? There you are. They all want to be like you.
Okay.
Maybe not politicians. So we've had a lot of email, just one second, there are a lot of email questions also. One wants to know whether you had any regrets, whether you feel you regret you signed the Bihar bill, president's rule, any regrets like that?
This question is asked number of times. As far as I am concerned, I don't have any regret in my decision. For example, when I Russia, when the Bihar dissolution proposal came, you were connected electronically. I am a connected fellow.
Right.
You follow electronically.
Very connected. Yes.
All the it's 10 years back. It is not possible. I am a connected fellow. Anywhere I get electronically all the information. I talk to Prime Minister number of times, and then I get the file, and then I ask questions. The file transferred electronically. I took a decision. So I stand by my decision. Okay, friends. Yeah.
Right. Now some more questions. So you choose.
Nara, you are giving a difficult last moment you are pushing.
Okay,
me.
This young girl right in front here must be the most keen if she's right in front. Yeah, go ask a question.
Sir, my name is Kanu Priya. You've been an inspiration for all of us. But who's been the source of inspiration for you?
Only one person. That is when I was a 10-year fellow, fifth class I was studying in Rameshram Island, okay? Rameshram Island. At that time I had one teacher. Sivasubramania Iyer. That Sivasubramania Iyer, he went to blackboard, and he explained how birds fly. The way he explained how birds fly, and the way he made us to ask questions, at the end of the class, I felt not only he taught me how birds fly, he injected me what should be my vision in life, what should be goal in life. So that's a great, teachers can do a very important role transforming the minds of the people. Okay, buddy. Okay.
Sir, one or two more questions. The girl on the left, the extreme left. Yeah, go ask your question. Yes, ask.
Sir, when you were the president, what has been one of your most difficult moments when it has come to decision making? And what was your secret of success? How did you eventually overcome when it comes to attitude?
The most difficult decision is I felt the office of profit bill,
most difficult decision.
The office of profit bill, and this bill, I have to so far no president sent to the parliament, so I happened to do that with a lot of thinking, lot of consultation. this because I felt I must do it. Of course, it create a lot of debate in the media, and also it create a discussion in the parliament, and they appointed a committee. I felt that, that is the office of profit okay. bill. Okay? Okay?
Who would you like? Who would you like to ask? Which one? Anybody? Anybody? Okay, this girl in front here, in the, have you asked a question?
Anybody.
Okay, then ask. Go ahead, ask.
Sir, you coming from a scientific background, a non-political background, and being thrust to the forefront as the president, did you feel alienated?
No, I learned very fast. I'm a
fast learner.
I learned. Within 6 months, I learned all.
Okay, the girl here, yes.
So I would like to ask that since being the president, you it would be a lot of stress. How did you handle that?
Stress.
You know, I have not felt any stress in my life in 5 years. Reason is I have got one habit. That habit is I walk 1 hour in my gardens. And 1 hour walk in my gardens, the all flowers smile. And sometimes the peacock dances. Sometimes the beautiful parrots all surrounding. I just the beautiful days I had. So the environment made me happy always. Always one information for all of you. Even one exam time, even exam time, whatever it is, make a habit. Make a habit in a beautiful park. Spend a half an hour. Okay. And also second thing is you remove the pain of the people. One person. You know, Mahatma Gandhi, when he was a 9 years boy, his mother, Mahatma Gandhi's mother advised, son, in your life, you remove, you save one person or and remove the pain of you. You have purpose of your life is fulfilled, my son, she said. Okay.
Okay, on that note, I think a round of applause to the professor, former president. You're extremely, thank you very much, sir, for joining us. You want to come and shake hands? Just shake hands for a couple of seconds. He's in a hurry also.
No, I will come.
Just to share.
Don't come on the stage.
One autograph,
only one. Well done, very lucky. Come, I think so.
Oh, the hand. What can I do? Each one of you get this.